It's Water Cooler Wednesday, our favorite day of the week. We're talking about a number of things. We've got Grammy nominations on our mind and a new style of Barbie doll.
Yeah, we have a lot to talk about this morning. Some great friends, radio host Mr. Myron Mays is here along with Kathy Hart and our own Todd Demers. Good morning, guys. Welcome.
Thank you.
Good morning.
All right. NBC.
What's happening, Myron?
That's it.
Right? We should just ask you.
Yes.
All right, get us started.
All right, well, let's start with the Grammys. You mentioned this yesterday, some Mid-Southerners, of course, nominated. Well, among the others, Record of the Year nominees include Adele for Hello, Beyonce for Formation, Lucas Graham, 7 years, Rihanna for Work, 21 Pilots for Stressed Out.
All right, Best New Artist, Kelsey Ballerini, the Chainsmokers, Chance the Rapper, Maren Morris, Anderson .Paak. Just to name a few guys, what do you think about this?
And you know, it's funny that, you know, by the time the Grammys come around, a lot of the songs that have been nominated have been like pounded in your head like for months and months on end, and you're thinking to yourself, wow, is that song still around?
It feels like
the song is like old by the time the Grammys come around.
Well, remember Formation really hit the news anyway, Super Bowl time, right? So that was like almost a full year ago.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She didn't win Person of the Year. You think she'll win for Formation?
I think she might.
Yeah.
I think she might.
It's going to be kind of interesting. She's also going up against Adele. So we're talking about two powerhouses right there,
yes.
Kathy.
Yes, and I love both of them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So you
it
know,
won't be
it's
interesting
a win-win.
Because Kanye's not there.
You are shaking
it
up,
to watch for
him to make a PSA.
Yeah. Todd, how do you kind of see it?
Well, you know, I'm not very familiar with about 80% of what is going up there, except when I'm in the car with the kids and they're playing with the radio stations, and most of the time on like 60s on 6, 70s on 7, the Sirius XM. So it's like, you know, until they start cranking up the radio and I go, who is this? What is this? And a couple of those songs sounded familiar. So I think social media may actually have an influence on the winners sometime this year for whoever's making those final decisions, seeing what's out there in the social media world.
So are you saying you're still waiting for like a Bing Crosby or Barry Manilow nomination?
You know, if it's the Eagles or Fleetwood Mac, you know, I'm really happy.
Back.
Hey, don't get me started. We'll get in the Carpenter here in just a minute if you don't care.
You know, now there's a category for music that is being streamed as well.
Really?
Yeah, so
just streamed like
because
so, not
so many people get their music from streaming as opposed to actually going out and buying it. There's a category for that.
Huh.
Yeah.
Yep. What'll they think of next? How about category for tantrums? The Biebs would win that in a walk. I'm sorry.
I don't think
that was
probably given out an award.
Yeah.
In the middle of the concert.
Or, yeah. Okay. Well, how about this? We talked about Barbie a little bit. There's a breastfeeding Barbie now. A woman in Australia has made this available on Etsy. It's not a Mattel, okay? But what she has done in the past is she has taken the Barbie doll look and she has created a look-alike, one that's pregnant, one that's breastfeeding. So, one thing that I was curious about is how is the waistline? You know how the waistline on Barbie is like 19 inches?
Right.
So in this fake Barbie, that's the pregnant one.
Okay.
So what do you think? You have a daughter, Myron. Now she's a little older than breastfeeding and then Barbie age.
Oh, well actually it's a boy.
Well, no, I'm talking about your other daughter, your daughter.
Other daughter. Oh, yeah.
yeah,
you know, it's just kind of weird because when I saw this topic, I'm thinking, wow, I experienced that at the house, like, right now.
A breastfeeding Barbie, right.
Exactly. And but, you know, it's funny, you know, as like, time goes on and things progress, there's no telling what will experience next. So what type of Barbie is going to be coming up next?
I know.
So you don't have an issue with this, or
no, not at all, not at all. There's worse, far worse things that are.
And they did make her look sort of disheveled, but because you know, breastfeeding mom, you're tired. You don't have time for like the mascara.
Right. She's not the glamorous Barbie,
right.
And
which
so
is
that's
good.
Which is good.
What do you think?
I think Because they're trying to expand Barbie.
Yeah.
You know, so they're going to have like a full figure Barbie and all this other kind of stuff. So I think we're trying to fit Barbie into mainstream, and we're trying to take kind of like the bullying out of Barbie. So
right, right.
I think the breastfeeding is, it's a little bit strange for me, okay? Only because I don't know little girls who would want to play with a breastfeeding Barbie. Most of the time it's Barbie and Ken and they're glamorous.
Yeah. I don't know if they want to play with them, but I do know, especially from the kids as they've been growing up in the house, they're very curious.
Yes.
And when there is breastfeeding going on in the house, I mean, the kids are going to be looking and say, Mom, what is going on? And,
yeah.
And I can see where little girls would be very interested in this and say, I want a doll just like what Mommy's doing with my baby sister
yeah.
right now. So it'll be interesting to see how that plays out as far as what kind of demand there is for that to
right.
see whether or not we're seeing it the same way they are.
But what do you think about having that conversation, though?
Yeah.
Oh, that's no problem at all. That's an easy conversation with the kids because it's all very natural. I mean, when you're around the house and Mama's breastfeeding, I mean, the other kids are going to see what's
yeah.
going mm-hmm. on.
And they're
gonna,
they should, because
they
it
should.
Is how
and
a baby's supposed
exactly.
to be fed.
Yes.
So maybe it brings it into the mainstream and more people
and
do it, which
much
is
more
ultimately
calm.
Healthy. So, right.
I'll invite you over to the house next time this is going on, Alex, and you can just see it firsthand.
I may pass on that invitation, but thank you anyway.
Patty's probably at home going, what? We're having another baby?
I don't know how Patty would feel about that. Alex is going to be doing well.
Patty wouldn't be as concerned about that as yeah. baby number six. I don't think so. No. I'm done.
That's your story right
speaking
there.
Speaking of babies,
yes,
though,
speaking of babies.
Look who we get to show.
Wow. Had no idea.
I know. Isn't Facebook great? You can steal people's
yes.
photos. So tell us about the baby.
Wow, he was 8 pounds, 9 ounces. His
Whoa.
Name is Kai
that's
Alexander
a, that's
Mays.
That's a big baby. That's
whoa, 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 what's the middle name?
Alexander.
For short, it'll be?
Probably Alex.
Thank you.
Yeah, probably Alex.
Thank you. That's all I needed to hear.
Beautiful baby. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. Any sleeping, we hope?
Not much at all. and neither are his parents.
Gotcha, Captain.
I remember,
right,
which is
guys.
Why Patty does not want number six.
Exactly.
Very good. Thank you all
exactly.
for being here. We appreciate it.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Thank you.